Hello and welcome to another one of my videos. I'm a little bit busy recently, but I have managed to get a few things done. The last thing we did with the hand generators was this yo-yo style hand generator, and there were a few recommendations that I made to improving it. Now I've done those improvements and I'd like to show them to you. So the main improvement was taking this big and small wheel here and making it into a double one of the same size with the string running between the pulley on the outside so it will align with the motor better. And I did have to spend $1 on a neoprene O-ring, but I think it'll last a bit better. So it functions quite nicely that way, and it functions even more stable lying down on the table. And so I have it connected to 20 LEDs here with a capacitor bank and a voltage regulator at 5 volts. The LEDs only need 3 volts, but the 5 will make sure it doesn't go further than that. And when I give a pull, another pull, it gets up to my 3 volts, and I can put a little bit more, and it will put a little bit more extra voltage into the capacitor bank. This is around 10 or 15 volts, and it will keep stable at the 5. It won't pass the 5. That's as brilliant as you get at 5 volts. Anything further than that, it will slowly drain until it gets to the 5 volts, then down to 3, and then the lights will start to dim as it goes down. So there's a little bit more storage having that voltage regulator and keeping it steady at 5 volts. It gives me about a minute's worth of light before I have to give it another pull. So it's reasonably efficient. Now excuse me, all of the electronics experts out there, and please correct me if I'm wrong, but it seems to me that this is what is happening with the voltage regulator. Here is a graph with voltage on this side here and time on this side here, and in a normal situation we have 3 volts is what our LEDs need. Here's my 5 volt regulator that's going to cut off here, and say my capacitors have say 15 volts capacity. When you charge up a capacitor say 15 volts, it will charge up reasonably quickly and get slower and slower and harder to get that voltage in until it peaks. Now when you discharge it, it will discharge at a lineal diagonal down that way until it gets lower and lower, and then the pressure and the voltage get less and it starts to drop off or take longer to discharge. An LED, when it needs its 3 volts here, I can charge up my capacitors and it will go up to here until it peaks somewhere, and then if I stop charging it before it gets way up there, it will then discharge, and the luminance or the brightness of the LEDs will very bright here, and then it will drop right from when I stop charging. The capacitors will drop off and start to dim and dim and dim until it gets to 3 volts, and then it'll get really slower in its dimming there because there's less voltage and pressure behind it. So we want to get rid of the really high brightness of the LEDs and also that minimize that lineal drop off so that it just continually getting dimmer and dimmer. Want it to be level as possible, but if you push the voltage up too high, you're going to burn your LEDs out. So I decided to put the lowest voltage regulator you can get is 5 volts, which is normal for a cell phone and things. So if you then charge the capacitors up, you can push the voltage up, say to 15 volts in this case, and it will charge up and charge up more, and then it will start to discharge through the LEDs at a reasonable brightness over its 3 volts, but not too bright, it's going to burn it out. And then it will slowly drain all of this energy that is in the capacitors at a regular rate, nice and flat, and the brightness will continue until it drops right off to the 5 volts again, and then it will drop below the 5 and continue on, and it's dimming as per usual. So by putting that voltage regulator in, I can push the voltage of my capacitors up a little bit and have a good period of time where I'm getting a good consistent brightness in my LEDs before it starts to drop off again. And that's what I'm getting at the moment with the capacitors, about 30 seconds of good even light before it drops off for another 30 seconds or so. So So that's where I'm at. So the voltage regulator was a good idea, it seems to me. Please correct me, all your electronics experts, if I'm wrong. But that's what it seems like to me. Now, I thought to myself that since it's lying flat here and is a little bit more stable, and I have a board on the bottom there, I thought I could put my capacitor bank underneath there and hide it in a little enclosed space. So I made up another capacitor bank like this, and this has about the same amount of storage as the other, but I have enough space to basically double my storage space to put underneath the little box there, enclose it in, and I will have 2 minutes worth instead of 1 minute before I have to pull it again. So that's a little more efficient and tidy.